Oh my god, hi you guys. I know, I'm sorry I haven't made a video in forever. It's been like 2 months. I just needed to take a break and regroup and, you know, just find myself because I wasn't happy with the content I was putting out. I don't know if I wasn't happy, but I wasn't liking the quality of the content I was putting out. So I had to take a break and I'm so sorry, but I am back and I am back with one of the most exciting videos I have ever made because you guys, I can finally talk about my bones set visit that happened on February 17th, 2016. Okay, so, well, I guess, and my LA trip in general because I haven't talked about that because I wanted to talk about it all together. So, I guess I will start with LA in general. LA is the most beautiful place I have ever been in my life. And, you know, I haven't been to many places, but LA was just absolutely gorgeous and I miss it every single day of my life. I really, really, really do. So, we arrived on Monday, February 15th, and we just did some sightseeing and, you know, normal touristy stuff. And then Tuesday, we went to Warner Brothers Studios, which was supposed to be the day I went to Boneset, but it had to be switched because of scheduling issues on their part. So I went to Warner Brothers instead. And you guys, it was so cool. I got to go to a bunch of different sets. I saw some of the Gilmore Girls revival being shot. I didn't see much. I didn't see any of the actors or anything, but I saw a little bit of Stars Hollow, and you guys, oh my god, I freaked out. It was amazing. I got to see a bunch of sets, you know, stages. We went to Conan O'Brien's stage. We went to, you know, the stage where Friends was filmed. Well, we saw the outside of it. I saw a little bit of the Big Bang Theory. Stage, so cool. Yeah, we just walked around. I couldn't go on one of the trams because my chair wouldn't fit on it. And they had like manual chairs, but I had to be pushed and I didn't want to do that. So we just did a walking tour, which was a lot better because I got to go in sets instead of just seeing them. So I recommend a walking tour if you're going to that. And then we just walked around a lot, to a lot of different stages, and then we went to the interactive stage where they keep part of the front set. And my family and I got to sit on the couch and, you know, be in the coffee shop, which was amazing. There was a bunch of you know, Harry Potter stuff. Oh yeah, and that reminds me, there was we went to like an archive of where they kept like all the Batman stuff and the Harry Potter stuff. The Batman stuff I didn't really care about because I'm not a superhero person. Sorry about the light behind me. It's my window. I'm trying to find. Oh, there we go. That's a better angle. You know, so we saw a bunch of like Batman stuff, and then we went upstairs and saw all the Harry Potter stuff. You guys, I like geeked out. It was amazing. I got sorted, and I am in Hufflepuff, which is awesome because I'm in Hufflepuff on Pottermore. So that was really, really cool. Yeah, it was just amazing. There's so many amazing costumes, and there's just so many cool things in the Harry Potter exhibit, which was great. And then, yeah, so that was Warner Brothers. And then Wednesday, oh yeah, and then after that, I think we went to Griffith Park and the Griffith Park Observatory, which was absolutely beautiful, you guys. You know, I'm not really a science freak or anything like that, but the view, oh my god, it was gorgeous. So pretty. So pretty. And then Wednesday, you guys, Wednesday, we went to the set of Bones. And oh my god, it was the coolest, one of the coolest experiences I've ever had in my life. Oh my god, it was amazing. So I was on the Fox lot, which is where they shoot Bones, for a total of 9 hours. 9 hours, you guys. That's insane. 9 hours. So, first, I think. Oh, yeah, and that was the only day it rained in LA while we were there. That specific day. Really? Thanks a lot, LA. Anyway, so yeah, first we got there. I was freaking out. It was amazing. We ate where the craft service people are, and like the food was amazing. And then after that we went to wardrobe, which was really, really cool. I got to see like a bunch of wardrobe from like a bunch of different movies and shows, which was awesome. And then I got to see where they keep like Booth and Brennan's stuff, like all the characters from Bones' stuff, which was awesome. They actually gave me two pairs of Emily's earrings, Emily Deschanel, who plays Brennan, that she doesn't wear anymore, which I thought was amazing. They just told me to pick the two, the one that looks most like me, but I thought both of them look like me, so they gave me both pairs, which I thought was incredible. They didn't have to do that at all. And then after we did that, well, actually, on the way to wardrobe, I actually met Tamara Taylor, briefly, who plays Camille Saroyan, the coroner, and who does all the autopsies, the boss at the Jeffersonian, if you watch Bones. She was so sweet. So then we did that, and then, after that, we went, like, just looking on all the sets. First, we went to the Jeffersonian, which was incredible. I got to go on the platform, because, as most of you know, and I don't mean to spoil this, but Hodgins, played by TJ Thine, got paralyzed and is now in a wheelchair. And so they had to build him a lift, so I was actually able to go on the platform, which was absolutely awesome. It was so cool. There was a dead body on the table. It was amazing. It does not smell like a dead body would smell, although I don't know what that smells like, but I can imagine it smells bad. It's all made of rubber and plastic. It takes about, I think they said a week to make them, which is so cool. It was amazing. And then after that, we went to Brennan's office, and there's so many cool things. So many cool things in there. There's like a mummy and so many cool artifacts. I got to go behind the desk and sit at her desk, which was so cool. And then after that, we went to Hodgins' lab, and I got to look around there, and it's really cool, which is also where Cam's office is. And I got to look there. That was really cool. And then we went to the FBI, I believe. Yeah, went to the FBI, which was really cool. I got to go in Booth's office, which was amazing. So cool. I got to go in the interrogation room, which was amazing. I tried to look scared, but I was just too excited, and I was smiling the whole time. And then we went to the conference room in the FBI, which was cool, you know, and then we went to the break room. And then after that, we went to Booth and Brennan's house, and oh my god, you guys, it was so pretty. They weren't using that set that day, so everything was covered up, but it was really cool to be there anyway. And then we went back to the set, the Jeffersonian, because that's where they were shooting. And Emily Deschanel, who plays Brennan, was on set. TJ Thine, who plays Hodgins, was on set. And Tamara Taylor, who plays Cam, was on set that day. So, Emily came in first, and she was like, you know, hi, are you Emma? And I was like, yeah. She's like, oh my god, it was so nice to meet you. It's so nice to meet you. And I was like, it's so nice to meet you too. And we hugged, and she was sitting right next to me. Her chair was right next to me. And oh my god, guys, she is one of the sweetest women I've ever met in my life. Just so, so sweet. And then Tamara Taylor came in after her, and she was just so sweet, really funny. And then the guest intern for that episode, BK Cannon, who is also Mary Beth on Switch at Birth, if any of you guys watched that. She was so, so funny and so sweet, and she is a very talented actor. And so they started shooting. I was just amazed. We actually got to sit in Video Village, which is where they watch the action. The director and everything, and the director of the episode was Michael Lang, and he is so funny and so nice. And actually, you guys, he let me direct a scene from the episode, which was such an incredible experience. I was like, what? I am not qualified for this. What are you talking about? He was like, you know, I want you to do this. I think you can. So he let me direct an entire scene, you guys, and it was just the most incredible experience of my life. It was the coolest, most wonderful thing that could have ever happened to me. And, you know, just, it was the most amazing educational experience I could have ever received, because, as you guys know, I want to be an actor, so getting to see the actors do what they do up close and personal, and getting to, you know, watch someone's vision come to life, you know, as a director, and getting to watch them do what they do on my command kind of was amazing. And it's definitely a new passion of mine that I didn't expect to have, but I'm glad that I do. And I will definitely be getting into directing down the line, but acting is my true passion, so that's first and foremost in my mind. But it was just amazing, and I can't believe that it happened, and it was just so cool, and I was so nervous, but everybody loved it and said I was did a fantastic job, and, you know, I told them to be honest with me because I wanted them to, you know, tell me the truth, and they said that I was wonderful, so I am inclined to believe them because they know what they're doing, and so that was amazing. And it's funny because we didn't actually talk about any acting stuff, which is what I planned to talk to them about most of all, because I wanted to get tips from them and stuff. But we actually wound up talking about normal life stuff, because that's what they wanted to know about me. They wanted to know about, you know, how I was, like, liking LA, you know, was it my first time, you know, all that kind of stuff. So I didn't wind up talking about acting with them at all, really. I mean, a little bit here and there, but, like, it's mostly just life stuff. So, yeah, and then, so that scene took about 2 hours, I think, because Emily Deschanel had a newborn baby. He was only 8 months old, so she was breastfeeding and had to pump, so she took like half an hour breaks, you know, every 10 minutes or so. So I had a lot of time, and then on one of those breaks, well, once they finished shooting the scene that I directed, they started shooting another scene, which is when TJ Thine came in, and oh my god, you guys, he is literally one of the sweetest men that I've met in my entire life. He was just so sweet. The minute he came in, he was in his chair, and he goes, "Where's Emma?" And I'm like, "I'm right here." And he's like, "It's so nice to meet you." I'm like, "It's so nice to meet you too." And he's like, "I can't hug you right now because I'm in my chair. So I'm gonna kiss your cheek instead." And I was like, "Okay, I'm not gonna object to that." So he kissed my cheek like 3 times, and he was just so sweet and adorable. And we started talking. We were actually comparing chairs because, as you guys know, I have a power chair, and he's in like a normal, regular, you know, chair. So he was like, "Can you give it to me?" I'm like, "No, if I could get around without it, I would, but I can't." So it was funny, and he was just so sweet and so nice. And so during one of the half an hour breaks that they took while filming the second scene, he said to me, "You know, I want to complain with you. Come on, let's go in the bone room." But then we couldn't go in the bone room because that was a hot set, which means everything is set for that scene, and so they can't move it. So we went and played in his lab, and he actually got like a skull and all this stuff, and we were looking at it, and I said, "You know, it would be really cool if I could wear a lab coat." Like, I was like, "I wish I had a lab coat," because, you know, he was in his lab coat and everything. So he was like, to one of the prop guys who was like standing right there, he's like, "Can I borrow a lab coat?" So I actually got to wear a lab coat, which was amazing. So yeah, then after that we just played, and I have some really awesome pictures of us just like pretending to be serious, looking at the skull, examining it and all this stuff. And then there were some silly ones, but yeah, he kept calling my parents Mama and Papa, which I thought was adorable. And then they went back to shooting, and I just sat there watching, completely amazed and bewildered by their incredible brilliance. It was incredible. And I know I keep saying incredible, and I keep, like, repeating the same things over and over again, but that's just because it was just amazing, and I couldn't have asked for anything better, except for maybe David Boreanaz being on set, because he was not shooting that day. So, unfortunately, I did not get to meet him, which was sad. But it was fun anyway. But then afterwards, they wrapped at about 9:30, and they started shooting about 4. So I was on set for their entire second half of the day. So that was amazing. I was watching them shoot for 5 hours, which was absolutely incredible, and I couldn't have asked for anything better. As each hour passed, I kept saying, "Please don't make me leave yet, please don't make me leave yet, please don't make me leave yet," because I didn't know how long I was able to stay there for, And they just kept passing by and passing by, and it was amazing. And then as they wrapped, I forgot to tell you guys, we went to the Fox store, Studio store, because I wanted to get stuff for them to be able to sign because I didn't have anything. So we bought a bunch of stuff. And Fox actually picked up the entire tab, which I thought was absolutely incredible because they didn't have to do that. It was amazing. And my father actually bought me a marker, like a director marker. And, you know, then at the end of the night, he sold Emily Deschanel to give it to me. And she was like, no. He was like, yeah, I want you to give it to her. So she gave it to me and goes, here, this is your director marker. And I looked down at it, and everybody signed it. And that's the first thing I noticed, which I kind of figured that was going to happen. I was like, oh, my God. And then I kept looking down, and there was all the official Bones labels, like Bones, the C number that I directed, like all that stuff. And then in the place of director, it said Emily Mansky. And, well, it said my name, and I couldn't believe it. I started sobbing like a baby, and I just couldn't believe it. I was sobbing. I actually got Emily to cry. I actually made Emily cry, which was something I never thought I would do, and I felt horrible. And then TJ was like trying to cry, and I just felt horrible. And I was like, no, don't cry, please don't cry. And then they were trying to take pictures, and